Good evening. Welcome back to my Life at Home concerts. I'm going to start playing tonight with a wonderful tune by Richard Rodgers called This Can't Be Love. I hope you enjoy.
Thank you.
Lovely.
Lovely bouncy thing.
Bouncy, bouncy. And not like Tigers. Tigers bounce heavy. And Richard Rogers bounces lightly and happily. I am going to play the last movement of the Haydn's Piano Sonata, one of his earlier sonatas in F, which I've played the first and the second movement in the last two nights. And now we're gonna do the last movement, which is called the scherzo, which in Italian means a joke. And Haydn universally is recognized as a joker and not the politically infested, I'm tempted to say joker, but a joker, the person who likes to make like-hearted, funny comments about things. And that comes through all of his music, including this particular wonderful piece. I'm gonna add a couple of ornaments to this, I think. An ornament at least, the trills, the more dance, the turnarounds, the things that the one time you play a single note and then next time you play something like that, you play something moving. And there's much debate on how to play ornaments in Haydn. As a matter of fact, I have a book that my mom brought to me from Moscow that has about 10 different writers, and each one of them talks very seriously about what ornaments are and how to play them in Haydn. And one of them mentions that although we don't have a sound recordings of Haydn playing his own music, because the equipment is not developed yet, we do have a fairly good idea of what he wanted, and here how goes. One of the Haydn students was a clockmaker and also made the music boxes. I should have brought one with me to demonstrate. Those little German machines that play music. And Haydn, being everybody's friend and a universally likable person, went to the guy's shop and programmed quite a few of those music boxes with his own music. So how loud or soft the notes are, we don't know, because the music boxes are not that responsive. However, we do know how the ornaments go, how fast or slow the ornaments go, and they are all over the place. Some trills are like slow, dibby-dibby-dibby-dibby. Some trills are... Some of them are long. Some of them are short. So they're all over the place. So Haydn treated ornaments as an improvisational tool to make music play more interesting and more enjoyable for himself and for his listeners. I hope you enjoy the scherzo from Sonata in F. Jimmy Van Heusen wrote the next song, which is called Like Someone in Love, and Jimmy Van Heusen wrote a lot of really, really beautiful ballads, very sensitive, romantic melodies. piece worthy of arranging for the symphonic orchestra sometimes. I hope you enjoyed this one. This is gonna be a wonderful, gorgeous ballad, like someone in love.
Thank you.
beautiful song. I'm going to play one more.
This one is called What's New, written by Bob Haggard. Hope you enjoy that one.
We're going to make it move again. Moving is good.
Thank you. I hope you enjoyed
this rendition of a wonderful tune called What's New. Thank you all for being here. Some of you night after night, I appreciate and respect and love all of you, even if it's your first time. And hopefully it's not going to be your last time. Thank you so much for letting me know that you are here, for making comments, sending me things, all of those things. We went through, I think I started with about 30, 40 views per episode, and that was about 6 months ago. Right now, I routinely get about a couple hundred. I think a few days ago was almost 400 views on one of these episodes, and I really don't know why. Like, I really don't know what people actually are looking for particularly, because the music changes all the time. I don't actually play the same tunes very often at all. In either case, we have been, I can't speak English, over 31,000 views on the project altogether, which is a lot of clicks and a lot of people listening. And that's kind of amazing to me. And in many ways, this has been my therapy and my exposure to a lot of new and different people. And I hope that I can kind of invite you to like the kind of music that I like. The fairly pure classical music that I play once in a while, and fairly pure and traditional jazz music, which I prefer to the things that are not necessarily all jazz, but use elements of. I think there's some sort of like inside part of the jazz idiom that's very, very almost religious. It's like DNA of the music. If the music is put together for the purpose of being music, and not necessarily for other things. And it makes it very enjoyable to me experience, and very classy and very nice. I hope I turn you into liking that kind of stuff, because we definitely need bigger audiences, better pianos, bigger rooms, all sorts of things like that. Thank you for being here, and please come back tomorrow night. Until now.